Hi, my name is Slava, and today I'm going to talk about Meteor and your text editor where you write code. So raise your hand if you use one of those, Emacs, Vim, or Sublime. Wow, I think it's like the whole room. So this talk is going to be helpful to you, I hope. So my first question is why you don't use Vim? I think Vim is the best editor. I know like the whole MDG actually uses Emacs, but I am hardcore like Vim only user. So there are actually some good reasons not to use Vim for web dev. And some of them are like the tool is not just good enough for JavaScript. And you don't get auto-completion, like jump to definition, all the good stuff that you are used to in like Java world or even Python. I don't know, even Python works well. Actually, you know, these editors are very cool. They're not even editors, they're called IDEs. Like Xcode for Objective-C, Eclipse for Java, Visual Studio for C#, they're great. And companies are investing a lot of money into it. And that's why these tools are so great. But you know, like Vim is not that bad, actually. There are plenty of plugins. Those bring you cool features for C++ or C# or Python. So it's not really a problem of editor. Editors are capable of doing that. So I thought there should be a project for JavaScript that does that, that brings all this static analysis to your code. And actually, there is one. It's called TurnJS. It's written by the author of Acorn and CodeMill. They're very cool projects. And actually, they already support Node.js, Angular, jQuery, underscore. And they didn't support Meteor for some reason. And I thought, it's a problem. So I took one weekend off. I've seen this super cool mailing thread telling us, like, OK, I found this thing called TurnJS. I think it's really cool. We should use it. And I thought, yeah, we should use it. And I hacked in one weekend. And that's what I have. You have smart completion based on your syntax. For example, it knows, I don't know, is it small? Like, it knows that it's your collection, and it shows you what are the methods on your collections. You can jump to definition. I can go to some call to my collection and then jump to the code part where this collection is actually defined. I can get references. Find me all the places where I use this collection. And it doesn't just do simple search. It actually does analysis on syntax tree to understand what actually happens. You can get docs. That's, I think, very important to have docs when you have a large code base. Not only docs for Meteor, but also docs for your internal code base. Type inference. So it's probably hard to see, but on the bottom, there is a line changing. Every time I go to a different symbol, it shows me what type is it. Is it an object? Is it a collection? Is it like a like computation? And that's what works. And I think it's really cool. So we have basic features of TurnJS. You have auto-completion. You have file scoping for Meteor. It means like if you declare something in one file, it will not be visible in the second file unless it's global. And it works. And also, we have a lot of definitions for Meteor. And I took it from type definitions for TypeScript. They're actually useful, very useful, thanks to all these people who did that. And we could utilize it in this project for JavaScript. What doesn't work? Renaming, refactorings don't actually work. Docs from docs.meteor.com don't actually work. Packaging scoping doesn't work quite yet. I'm planning to spend another weekend working on that. And it would be nice if we could generate all these definitions for Meteor for every new version of Meteor in the future. So I'm not going to do it manually, you know. So this is a link on GitHub. It's called Turn Meteor. It's just a plugin for Meteor system, Turn system. And it actually works for all these three editors, Emacs, Vim, and Sublime Text. I also have instructions and video screencasts how to install them. People report that they actually work. So what's next? I want to work on those features, those don't work. I am encouraging people who want to join me to contribute. So for example, you don't actually need to know how to hack on, I don't know, like manipulate ASTs and stuff like that. What you can do, you can write definitions for your favorite packages. I just talked to Bo from Event at Mind, and he said like he's going to hack on it and bring definitions for Iron Auto, for example. And you can do it for your favorite packages as well, like Meteor Collection 2 or like forms and stuff like that. So that's it. Please use it. Yeah.
Questions?
Oh, good. Okay. Yeah?
Can you make a nice syntax highlighter for space bars?
Can I make a nice syntax highlighter for space bars? I'm not actually that good in Vim script yet. So I was hoping someone will build it. So right now I just use it, just HTML, like syntax highlighter, I don't know. And you know, I think we are not using handlebars anymore, we're using spacebars, right? So maybe it will change, so it's not clear yet. Anything related to actual completion stuff? I can show you GIFs again, like they actually work. So you jump to reference, you know? Okay.
Quick question about spacebars. What is it?
What is spacebars? So I don't think I'm super qualified to answer this question, but I think spacebars is actually something you used to call handlebars for Meteor. Actually, it's not handlebars anymore. It's been like, I don't know, more than years that it's not handlebars. It's a fork of handlebars, and now it's a completely right of handlebars in Meteor. So yeah, I think it's going to change somehow. I'm not sure. So yeah, no questions?
Thank you.
Use it, please.